Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jones.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. You say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem. Great. Welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jones. Great question today, sent in by Uma. Uma has a list of names in column B, and Uma says for every name, she wants to create a worksheet in a new workbook and name the worksheet after that name. All right, now yesterday we solved Terry's problem using a recorded macro. This is a macro that we're not going to be able to record, and so let's switch over to Visual Basic and we'll talk about this macro that I wrote. Still a short little macro, about 20-25 lines. Up here, I'm defining some object variables, WBT and WBN. Those are workbooks. WBT is this workbook, the workbook that we're starting from, and WBN is a new workbook that I'm going to create. WST is the original worksheet, and WSN is the worksheets that I'm going to create. So right up here, I say, hey, WBT is equal to the active workbook, and WST is equal to the active sheet. I know as I go through, I want to add those sheets at the end of the workbook, and so I set up a little variable here called counter that tells me how many worksheets I'm doing. And then this is the part the macro recorder will never ever get, the loop. We're going to say for each cell in selection. That gives us, makes us this macro very, have a lot of flexibility. We can select any range of cells and it will loop through all of those cells. And first I check and see if the counter is equal to 1. If it is, then I use workbooks.add and this very strange word, XLWBAT worksheet. That says, hey, create a brand new workbook with a single worksheet, no matter what their settings are. How many sheets in a new workbook? You know, that varies from computer to computer. Some people have it at 3, some people have it at 1. I don't care what that setting is. I want a single worksheet and define WSN as that first worksheet. If it's past the first cell, then I just want to use the existing workbook, WBN.worksheets.add, add it after the last workbook, and again, assign that to the variable name WSN. Now, a couple of things here, WSN.name is equal to cell.value. I wrap that in on error resume next and on error go to zero. That's just in case the cell contains an illegal character, you know, an exclamation point or something that you can't have in a name, at least it'll keep running. And then in cell A1, that's row 1, column 1, put the name of the worksheet. Just, I don't know if Uma needed that, but I added it in. Finally, keep track of our counter. After I'm done with the macro, make sure that I go back and select the first worksheet. So, hey, let's try this out. I'm just going to select some cells here, and we'll go to our macros here, choose Make Workbook, and click Run. And what we're going to see is very quickly, there is a brand new workbook with all of the different sheet names from our original worksheet. Great way to go. You know, it takes a few lines of code, but once you have those code, you can then very quickly create a workbook with new worksheets based on the cells. Well, I want to thank Uma for sending that question in. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel. Well, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.